Hey everyone, good morning. I welcome you all to the Morning Tales for May 2nd, 2019. And without wasting any time, let's start with the first question. So the first question is, which of the following has been barred by SEBI from accessing the capital markets for 6 months? So SEBI here means the Securities and Exchange Board of India. And in a very big step, they have banned the National Stock Exchange, that is almost holding the largest share in the equity share segment. They have been barred from accessing the capital markets for 6 months. Also, they have been fined with 1,000 crore, which is actually 624.89 crore plus the 12% interest rate since April 1st 2014. So since then, it is believed that they have been not exercising the due diligence while they are offering the co-location facility to the brokers. Now, what does this co-location, or we know that this is the reason behind SEBI barring the National Stock Exchange. So co-location basically means when the broker's server is actually kept in the exchange premises so that they could reduce the delay in the computing terms while we are executing the trades. So this is what the co-location means, and for this reason the SEBI has barred the National Stock Exchange. But it has been explicitly mentioned by the and said by the CEO and MD of National Stock Exchange that the regular trading on the stock exchange would not be affected. So it might not affect the traders directly, but it might affect them indirectly. Now, as the MD and CEO have said such statement, who is the MD and CEO of National Stock Exchange? You're going to write the answer in the comment section below. Who is the current MD and CEO of National Stock Exchange? Moving on to another question, and before going to the next question, I would like to tell you that at the end of the video, I have kept a question, a quiz of the static question. Simultaneously, I'll be providing hint, but the answer would not be provided by me. You need to mention the answer in the comment section without Googling. So make sure to watch the video till the end. So according to data released by SIPRI, that stands for Stockholm International Peace Research Institute, India was the world's dashed biggest military spender in 2018. Very important question. So coming directly to the answer of this question, as per the ranking given over here, India is at the fourth position in 2018. So US is at the first position with approximately $649 billion of spending. China at second position, and if we talk about India, then $66.5 billion of the spending was done on the military, which is contributing approximately 3.7 to the total world's spending. That is the, so these countries, this pie chart is representing the country's share in the total spending around the world. And if we take into consideration the top 5 economies, then they are contributing approximately 60% to the total of the world's share. Now let's look at the number, how much is Pakistan spending? So quite interesting to know that Pakistan is at the 20th position and spending just 11.4 billion on their military. Spending such little amount, and still the experts say that the India's military spending was insufficient against the challenges which we have faced in the, or we have faced from the neighborhood. So coming back to the question, it's very important to learn the top 5 economies and especially India. Moving on to the next question for today. So who among the following has got a silver medal in the Asian Weightlifting Championship 2019? First of all, the Asian Weightlifting Championship was held in Ningbo, China. And India has been awarded with the 3 medals, that is 1 silver and 2 bronze. So the single silver medal which was awarded in Asian Weightlifting Championship to Indian was Jhili Dhalbera. She is actually the World Championship bronze medalist, and now she has clinched the silver medal in the women's 45 kg category. If we talk about the 2 other bronze medals, one was awarded to Meera, one was won by Meerabai Chanu, and another one was won by Pradeep Singh. So Asian Weightlifting Championship was held in Ningbo, China, where Jhili Dhalbera won the silver medal and Meerabai Chanu and Pradeep Singh won the bronze medals. Next question is, a new committee has been constituted by the Environment Minister to implement the NCAP, which aims to cut pollution in the 102 worst affected cities. NCAP was actually or originally launched in January 2019. And now they have set up a committee to implement this NCAP across the 102 cities. So what does NCAP stand for? So NCAP actually stands for National Clean Air Program, and it has the aim to reduce the pollution, the air pollution in these 102 worst affected cities by 2024, and that too by 20 to 30%. So a committee has been formed by the Environment Ministry, which would be headed by the Secretary of the Environment Ministry itself. Now let's talk about this NCAP. So as I just told, it was launched in January 2019, and that too by the Environment Ministry itself. And Maharashtra has the largest number of cities, 17 cities among these 102 affected cities, which is followed by Uttar Pradesh with 15 cities. So a question might come other way around as well, that which emission has been launched to combat air pollution across these 102 cities. The next question, and very important question, India Ratings and Research, which is the Fitch Group company, it has lowered down the India's growth forecast to dash from 7.5% for financial year 20. So previously they predicted the India's growth forecast to 7.5%, but now they have lowered it down to 7.3%, and that is basically due to the below normal monsoon prediction which has been done by the IMD and loss of momentum in the industrial output. So this is the basic reason why IRR has lowered down the India's growth forecast to 7.3% for financial year 20. Now there are other organizations as well which are predicting the or which have lowered the GDP forecast for India. So after ADB, RBI, now IRR has also lowered the growth forecast. And what is the current growth forecast by ADB, that is the Asian Development Bank, and RBI? So it stands at 7.2%. For IMF, it's again 7.3%. So ADB, RBI at 7.2%, and IMF and Fitch IRR at 7.3%. Now here comes the question for the quiz. Where is Papikonda National Park located? First of all, you need to know why this national park is important and why this question has been created over here. So of the total 13 protected forests in the state in which this national park is located, the leopard cat has been sighted only in this Papikonda National Park. Now coming to the hint for that question, so there are two other national parks in the state, the first one being the Sri Venkateshwar National Park and another one being the Rajiv Gandhi National Park. So out of these states, you need to mention your answer in the comment section without using Google, because even if it is incorrect, we'll correct you in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching the video, and do not forget to subscribe if you have learned anything from the video. Along with this, the bell icon is next to the subscribe button. You will get the notification as and when the video is posted. So press the bell icon for that. Thank you so much for watching the video.